Hello students, today we are going to see the as a recall or revision of the topic of difference between adult and the child, one of the important topic. Moving on to the introduction, there are many difference between the children and the adult, like physiological, anatomical, cognitive, social and emotional. As we already know about the theories about psychological, psychosocial, psychoemotional, or moral or cognitive, everything was already we had studied. Over those differences, if you are saying it, entirely the kids were different when compared to the adult. Or we can able to say in another form, by learning or by doing, by getting experience, getting exposure to the activities, automatically the kids are maturing towards the adult. So these all impacts on the way illness and disease present in children and young people, as well as the way healthcare is provided. So here mainly we are going to see the difference between child and adult, systematic or systemic changes. One, system wise, like physiological changes. Then second one, psychological changes or differences. And the third one, pathologic changes. The third one we are going to see about pathological changes. So moving on to the anatomic and physiologic differences. So over this concept of anatomical and physiological differences, if you are coming, newborn's head is larger and heavier as compared to his body, where the adult, if you are seeing the adult's body as compared to the body proportion, the heads are not that much heavier. So newborn head is larger and heavier when compared to the adult. Yes. The next, the skin is thinner for the children when compared to the adult, because it's matured. All the physiological functions as well as the skin functions, if you are taking, it's entirely different when the children when compared to the adult. Then rapidly dividing cells in children, we can able to identify, where in adult it is a normal division of cells. Then no tears in early infants. Then there is tear formation in eyes, depends on the individual's emotional factors. Next, no voluntary control over the environment or activity, where adult is having completely controlled. This already we know very well. Next, anatomical difference. We are coming to or moving on to anatomical difference. The first and foremost we identify is the size of the child. The size of the child according to the different age group. It is varying according to the different age group. Then second one is the weight. Newborn head has, compared to the body, if you are saying the newborn head and the weight is proposing more or equal towards the body length when compared to the adult. Adults are having a small head and remaining maximum portions are present over the torso and the lower extremities. Where when the newborn, if you are seeing, the heads are larger when compared to the other positions like torso and extremities. Immaturity and inadequate ossification prone for injuries, particularly for the newborn baby. The bone ossifications, it takes time for the child and depends on the nutritious supply as well as the growth and development. Then sutures and skulls are not fully closed or it's not united at the birth. They are floating bones. Then frontals are not closed. Shape of the head and chest can be altered by constant pressure from lying in one position. Then muscles are 25% of weight in infant and it is 40% in adult. And as well as if you are seeing, 80% of body weight of the child is composed of fluid, when compared to the adult it is 60%. Then drug dosage, excessive IV fluids and medications easily cause pedal edema in infant cases or in children. Hence rate of flow should be always adjusted and the drug has to be calculated according to the necessary age factor as well as the weight factor. Then mouth. Moving on to the mouth, infant tongue is large, nasal and oral airway passages are relatively small, making the baby more prone to airway obstruction. Then nose breathers till 6 months, they are nose breathers till 6 months of age. So they are not a mouth breather. So any infection comes or any obstruction on the nose, it leads to breathing difficulty due to respiratory infection. then eyes. No tears in early infancy due to poor functional development of lacrimal gland. Then estrician tube. If you are coming to the estrician tube which is present at the connection present between the mouth as well as the nose as well as the ear. So it is short and straight in children, 10 degree in children and 40 degree in adult. So due to the 10 degree and shorter distance, easily the child will get air sinuses, which is directly spreading the infection from throat infection towards ear or ear infection towards throat. So here more common problem or presents are otitis media. The common complication of respiratory tract infections are otitis media. It may be acute or chronic because due to the shorter estrician tube, the infection spread from the respiratory tract or from the throat or from the pharynx towards the estrician tube and affect the middle ear. Then trachea. Short and narrow trachea under 5 years susceptible to foreign body aspiration. Short and narrow trachea. Then GI tract. GI tract, if you are saying in children, cardiac sphincter of the stomach is relaxed. So more possibility are there the content to be backflow. Backflow. So that will leads to vomiting is so frequent. Hence, proper positioning of the child during feed is so important. Then poor protection of the liver and spleen prone for trauma. It is not completely protected under because the ribs are under development. They are not that much strong. Then exertions by utilizing energy substrate for the process of growth. The load presented to the excretory pathway is decreased. So due to utilizing energy substrate for the process of growth. So the child need excess amount of growth. So further the child has to forwarded excess amount of energy has to be produced. So the load presented to the excretory pathway is decreased where it can't able to pick up the load. So over this, if you are coming, the systematic differences, we are going to see about different system wise. Different system wise, we are going to see that. Like example, if you are seeing integumentary system, respiratory system, cardiovascular system, then hematological system, urinary system, genitourinary system, gastrointestinal system, endocrine system, reproductive system, musculoskeletal, neurological system, lymph or immune systems. Over this, if you are saying simple form, if you want to say the adults are having larger body surface when compared to the child, that is the head is larger occupying for the children. The next, rapidly dividing cells were present in the children. They will easily get. Then weak immune system were present in the children or underdeveloping immune system. They are under development. That is present. Then thinner skin is present for them. Then higher respiratory infections are chances are there as well as higher respiratory rates were present. The next, physiological difference, absolutely measurements, rapid loss of 35 ml of blood via newborn baby represented 10% of blood volume. 35 ml of blood via newborn, by a newborn, rapid loss. Example, like umbilical cord clamping or in those cases, 35% of blood losses were present means that will represent 10% of blood volume of the child. So this much loss can lead to circulatory failure. The next, basal metabolic rate. BMR rate is high in newborn. In neonate, it is 6 to 8 ml of oxygen per kg per minute is normal, whereas 2 to 4 ml of oxygen per kg per minute is normal in adult. So newborn is needed 6 to 8 ml per kg per minute, where adult needed 2 to 4 ml. Next, increased carbon dioxide due to more metabolic rate. Temperature regulations, that is another one. Poor thermoregulation is attribute to immaturity of the hypothalamus, where hypothalamus is not fully mature or it is under development. So due to the temperature was not under the control or thermoregulation is not maintained. Shivering and sweating mechanisms are absent in newborn. Only thing we can able to see that either for a sense of touch, whether it is extremely cold or normal temperature is present. By touching the baby, you can able to identify. Then brown adipose tissue in newborn. Reverse of brown fat from which heat can be liberated by non-shivering thermogenesis. Once used, brown fat cannot be replaced, where the brown fat, which is stimulated by the passage of the blood vessels, be that it will reflect the temperature. The next, voluntary control. No voluntary control over the environment or activity. So no cold day adult used to wear socks, woolen cloths, etc. But the child depends on the care takers. So proportion of water, if you are seeing, the intracellular fluid is less for the child, where the extracellular fluids are more, that is double than the adults. Then easily fluctuates during the GI infection due to vomiting or diarrhea. Then blood volume. Blood volume, if you are coming for neonate, is having 85 ml per kg of body weight, where blood volume is present. Where in adult, it is about 60 to 70%, 60 to 70 ml per kg of body weight. Then glomerular filtration rate. If you are coming for glomerular filtration rate, concentration of urine in newborn is 800 osmol per liter, whereas in adult it is 1400 osmol per liter. Okay, so in newborn it is concentration, urine concentration is 800, where in adult it is 1400. Then glomerular filtration rate, glomerular filtration rate and tubular function are lower in neonates than adult, because low blood supply to kidney and smaller pore size and less filtration power across nephrons. This is another one main reason, because due to the normal placement of our cardiovascular system, the arch of aorta, already I said, the arch of aorta, which supplies 3/4 of the blood to the head, neck and shoulder, where these positions receive 75% of the blood supply, that is 3/4, where 1/4 of the blood supply furthermore descends down and supplies the remaining portions. Where the remaining portions means after the shoulder and chest, next it has to move down, then stomach, then move down towards the lower extremities. So over this, it has to reach to the kidney. So during that time, kidney will have a less proportion of blood supply or oxygen rich supply. Out of 25%, it has to receive some percentage of blood, where remaining places it has to be passed over. Then when it is reaching to the kidney, approximately 10% will be left over, where they will be receiving the 10% of oxygen supply or oxygen rich blood supply. So due to that, they are under poor development. So due to that, they can't able to function properly. So the glomerular filtration as well as tubular function was lower. So glomerular filtration is 38 ml per minute for neonate, where in adult it is 125 ml per minute. So GFR rate, 38 ml in neonates and 125 ml in adults. The next, integumentary system. If you are going to integumentary system, the apocrine sweat gland, small and non-functional from birth to preschooler, around 6 years. Then start functioning at 8 years of age, where apocrine glands are properly functioning for adults. The next, skin problem are linear disease, then scleroderma neonatorum, then tina capitis, then tina pedis, where these are the possibility are there excess skin diseases, where in this type of skin problem not seen in the adult, like rashes were present, like pimple like cheeses, or due to example like filling of the milk, the mother's milk, that will spill over the skin, where you can able to see like white like patches or white like pimples were present around the areas. You can able to see these are the diseases. The next, respiratory system. Moving to the respiratory system, child respiratory rate is 30 to 60 breaths per minute, where the heart rate is 100 to 160 beats per minute. Where in the adult, the respiratory rate is 16 to 20, where the heart rate is 60 to 80. The next, the issue of respiratory tract are delicate and do not produce sufficient mucous membrane, where sufficient amount of mucus has been produced. Then no protection from invasion of infectious or infectious microorganism, where protection from invasion of infectious microorganism in adult is present. So these are the difference. The respiratory rate is, compared to the adult, it is more. The next, the issue of respiratory tract are, there is less production of mucous membrane. The next, there is no protection for the invasion of microorganisms when compared to the adult. The next, we are moving to the difference between adult and fetal circulation. Adult circulation, if you are seeing, the arteries, the veins, exchange of gases and pressure. Over that, the arteries carries oxygenated blood away from the heart, where carries non-oxygenated blood away from the fetal heart. This is our fetal circulation. The next, veins carries non-oxygenated blood towards the heart, then carries oxygenated blood back to the heart. Then exchange of gases, if we're taking, takes place in the lungs. Here takes place in the placenta for the fetus. Then pressure, increased pressure on the left side of the heart. Here increased pressure on the right side of the heart due to the fetal circulation, because it has the foramen ovule, which is allowing the blood to pass from the left to right shunt. Next, hematological system. So hematological system, if you are coming, newborn RBC, when compared to the adult, if you are seeing, the microcytic or MCV will be less than 80 for newborn. When in adult, if you are seeing, the macrocytic will be present, that is MCV more than 100, it is present. Then lifespan of RBC, if you are seeing, 60 to 90 days for newborn, where in adult it is 100 to 120 days. Then blood volume in neonates are 85 ml per kg of body weight. The blood volume in adult is 60 to 70 ml per kg of body weight, because of the normal bone marrow, which is matured enough to produce sufficient amount of our matured RBC. So due to that, the adult lifespan will be 100 to 120, where in infant or in children, the bone marrow are immature or they are under development. So due to that, they can't able to produce matured RBC. So only the lifespan is breaking down within 60 to 90 days. Then urinary system. If you are seeing urinary system, children, infants, kidney are immature with reduced ability to filter and concentrate. And kidneys of adults are matured enough to function properly. Nephrons are not grown and functioning in children, but nephrons are properly functioning in adult. Then nephrons are not under voluntary control, under voluntary control in adult. These are the main, already I had said, the blood supply, because 25% of blood supply has to supply towards the stomach, then kidney, then lower extremities, where 75% blood supply were received by the neck, chest and shoulder, neck and the head, because of the formation of our aortic arch or aorta. Aorta is formed like that. Aorta leaves the heart, left side of the heart. After leaving the left side of the heart, it forms the arch of aorta. At the arch of aorta, there is a three branches are leaving towards the shoulder, chest, shoulder, neck and head. So due to that, what happened? 3/4 of the blood will escape towards that direction. After that, it further carry forward as descending aorta. So due to that, 1/4 possibility are there to descend down and passes to the remaining parts of the body. So due to that, less oxygen supply will be received or in the kidney. So due to that, the kidney takes time for the maturation or for the growth and development. Next, gastrointestinal system. Gastrointestinal system, it is quite relaxed in infants, resulting in frequent regurgitation and vomiting during infancy, where adults are having proper sphincter control. Okay, so GI system functioning is immature and involuntary in children, where properly it is functioning and in the proper control. Then the children will have temporary teeth, where adults are having permanent teeth. Then stools of neonate is loose, because liver is only 4% of the body weight and not matured enough. The stools of adults are hard. Liver is 12 to 13 times bigger when compared to the birth weight, or at the birth weight, how much it is. So here liver are also under development. Next, moving on to the endocrine system. If you are seeing children and adult, we are having two divisions. If you are seeing about children, endocrine glands which secretes hormones are least developed at birth, and where in adult it is properly developed. So many reasons are there. Like example, if you are seeing the floating bones, like the skull bones, they have to unite together. After uniting together, they will make a formation of layers. After that, they will protect the layers. So where the blood supply will be properly distributed. That the hemostatic control is lacking till age of 12 to 18 months, because they are also under development. The next, reproductive system, girl and boy. So girl, if you're taking, ovaries in a baby girl are approximately 10 mm in length and 2 to 4 mm in width. So functioning of ovary started at the age of 12 to 13 years of age. Then faulty development of ovaries lead to precocious puberty or delayed puberty. Then wherein the boy's testis in male baby at both are 1.5 to 2 cm long and 0.7 to 1 cm wide. The size of testis increases gradually and reaches maturity between the age of 13 to 17 or above. Okay. Then musculoskeletal system. The sutures in skull of newborn are not united. The infant bones are neither as firm nor as bristle as of adult. So fractures rarely occur in infant. If at all they occur, healing is very weakly in infant. In children, because they are floating ones, so they will absorb, they doesn't penetrate or they doesn't allow the shock waves to cross over. So if the child is getting a hit or blow towards the head will not vibrate entirely. It will get vibration only towards the area where it has been get affected. Then in children, height increases as bone grow at epiphysis, whereas in adult, height does not increase after a certain age. This is about frontal and bony plates, anterior and posterior frontal. So moving on to the neurological system. Children, the weight of brain of the neonate is about 300 to 500 grams, where in adult it is 1300 to 1400 grams. Then reflexes are active and they are present during infancy. Disappears in adult, and if it is present, some of the reflex which has to be present in infancy, then it is considered as neurological problem in adult. Then vision, eyes are anatomically not matured enough, not able to function properly. Like example, within 3 months they can't able to visualize the distance. At the same time, they can't able to see 180 to 360 degree directions. The next, hearing, if you're saying unit can hear loud noise at birth, but adult can listen all type of voices and sounds. Then lymphoid and immune system. The maturation of lymphoid system varies with the child age. The lymphoid tissue is smaller but well developed at birth. It increases rapidly in size up to the age of 10 to 11 years. Physiological differences. If you are coming for infants or newborns, if you are having fear, escape and avoid strangers, these were present as well as they live in the present. They never think about the past as well as the future. Same in infant also, more bonding with parents, separation anxiety they can able to identify. Then toddler, negativity behavior will be present like temper tantrum, negativism, adamant, these will be more common. Then preschooler, short attending span, they can't able to concentrate properly, easily distract by any voice or any sound or any kind of activity. Then schooler age group, if you think industry versus inferiority, they has to produce their own talent, and by showing the child you are not producing anything, automatically the child will move to inferiority. Then adolescent, identity of peers and confusion. In adolescents, they has to identify about their own role as well as the own freedom of work, how well they are giving their identity among the peer groups. If they are not fails to produce, then they will move to the format of confusions. So social and emotional development, if you are taking, there will be hospitals, peers, school and parents. In all this activity, how well they are getting developed according to the age group. If you are coming for the peer groups, particular age group, when the children start to go for the school, that time they'll be having only specific 1 or 2, 3 friends, and remaining members are not their friends, or depends on their needs, the peer friends will be present. But once the child is crossing the schooler age group, automatically their peer group and their friendship has started to develop. Okay. And the children, once they are growing upon, they leave the parents. That is, from the dependence from the parents, they start to move away from the parents. That is, from dependence of the parents towards, they are moving towards the independence. Then about reaction towards the hospital. Reaction towards the hospital also, at the different age group, the child shows different kind of adjustment. Like example, if you're taking infant, separation anxiety will be present. But in case of toddler and preschooler, they exactly know what is hospital means. Surely there will be some harmful or painful procedure will be there. And due to that, the child will get excess fear, instrumental fear, and separation anxiety. This everything will be present for the toddler and schooler age group. The next, cognitive development. Moving on to the cognitive development, if you are seeing, sensory motor, pre-operational, concrete operational, and formal operational. At the both to 2 years of age, the child will be having the cognitive will be only moving around their sensory and motor functioning. About the sense, utilizing their sense by visualizing and moving, by hearing and moving towards the that direction, that will be more common here. The next, during the pre-operational stage, that is from 2 years to 6 years of age, here the child uses the symbols to representate the object. Like simple example, the child will uses the plate, or by seeing the zero, the child will resemble or recall the moon or sun or the eating plate. This everything will be recalled. So where the symbolic representation will be more common. The next, concrete operational, that is 6 to 12 is the child can think logically about concrete object and can thus add and subtract. The child also understand conversation. Then formal operation, if you are thinking, the adult can reason abstractly and think hypothetically terms. So where they had matured enough, they can able to think properly and give the rational also properly. So this is about today's class, the difference between adult and the child. Then last one is pathological changes. Over the pathological changes, if you are seeing, imbalance of fluid and electrolyte will be present. The next, resistant to disease due to poor immune system. Then signs and symptoms of disease in children are different from adults. Thank you.